is a classic physics question to try and calculate the speed of a bullet, specifically by imagining it being shot into a pendulum and then looking at how much the pendulum moves. But this is normally done in theory. I thought it was high time someone actually shot a bullet into an actual pendulum and then did the actual working out, which is why I'm here in a freezing cold shooting range under a motorway overpass in Cambridge with everyone's favorite domesticated engineer, Hugh Hunt. This is the pendulum kindly made for us by the Cambridge Engineering Department. So Hugh, you know from other videos.
Hi,
and Maria, also from the engineering department, and they're currently timing the period of the pendulum, which is roughly 10 kilograms. What is it? Engineering exam?
Examples papers.
Examples papers.
These are the problem sheets they do during the week. And
so it's actually engineering questions being used to answer an engineering question. Now, I'm not qualified to shoot the gun, but veterinary science student Katherine here is. So, what will you be shooting?
We'll be shooting a .22 target rifle.
Excellent. Let's do it. We started with a few test shots to see how the pendulum would swing.
Because we don't quite know where the centre of mass of this thing, because it's wobbling like that, right.
Yeah.
So, what we're trying to do now is figure out where you should aim for,
okay,
as in left and right. So my guess is it should be somewhere about here, because...
It worked, there was some movement. We're just moving the bullseye to where the center of mass is, and we're now going to set up a system so we can get the exact measurement around the back. We've got a box which the pendulum will push back, and then that will record how far it was swinging. Actually, I'm going to swing it around, because I put an arrow on, but that's not how it... Good, good, good. Yep. It slid, because it was a bang on 13 to start with.
Bang on 13, and the middle of the box looks like it'd be around about...
Two and a half centimetres?
2.5 centimetres, 25 millimetres.
That's about right. So, I reckon we dig the bullet out.
Yeah, let's dig the bullet out. Let's be
fun. Weigh it.
Okay.
I'm going to very carefully remove that target tape.
Oh, look, an Aspie chart.
I mean, they're straight into the scatter chart. I mean, Katherine was a bit less active.
Hey, 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 look, bullet points.
Oh, wait, wait, bits of metal. Should we make a little pile of
shrapnel? Oh, it is
shrapnel.
They are shrapnel-y.
That's
still dented.
Like,
that still took some force.
Yeah.
Should we make a pad just a little bit bigger than that? We have a new smaller mass pendulum. How much are we on now?
Well, oh, it's about a quarter of the one we had.
Quarter of the original. So we're expecting roughly what? Four times the swing?
Four times the swing, because, yeah, if the velocity goes up by four, the amplitude of swing should go up by four.
Let's find out.
Yep. Are you using a bigger gun?
If
it was meant to go 10 centimetres, said 2.5, right, and it was at 13, yeah, it should have ended there, right?
What I'm wondering is, was it here, and then it got shot, like...
Yes. Given the mass scaling.
Love it.
There you go. Woo-hoo.
So we're weighing the fragments from the four bullets, at least the bits we found. So we actually got an actual bullet with the casing and everything taken off so we can weigh what it should be.
So this bullet should, with any luck...
And it is 2.6. 2.6. Okay, so we lost a little bit of...
Lost about half a gram of bullet.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
2.6 grams. Just like I got someone more qualified to shoot the gun, I have someone more qualified to do the maths. Hugh, let's do this.
Right. Well, look, we've got this bullet.
Yep.
And let's say it has mass little m, and it's going at velocity little v.
Which is what we're going to find out.
So it has momentum mv.
Makes sense.
And then it hits a block of paper, which has got mass big m and velocity big v after it gets embedded. And I'm just going to assume that because the mass of the bullet is small, that
it vanishes.
It vanishes.
And we weighed the bullet, and it's like 2.6 grams, and this is like 10 kilo.
Right, right. So the momentum before has to recall the momentum afterwards. What's happening is that the speed, the bullet comes in, hits the thing, and it lifts
just
this
tips
up,
it up. Yeah.
By a certain amount. The gain in potential energy must have been the kinetic energy that it had. The kinetic energy is a half mv squared. So I need to work out that height that it moves up.
From there to there. And then we know that half mv squared coming in is equal to mgh going up.
That's it. So if that's height h, and this is big V, we've got a half mv squared equals mgh. But the thing is that we're not going to measure that height. We're going to measure this.
Yes, we know that displacement.
Distance. Yep. Okay, so that distance is x. How do we work out h?
Well, we need a way to go from x to h. Put it in there. Get big V.
Okay, so if we think of this as angle theta, because that's going to give me L theta, where theta's in radians. Okay?
Yeah.
And then H is going to be L 1 minus cos theta. And that is approximately equal to a half L theta squared.
So you're small angling again
small
on
angling,
this. Yeah, that's fine.
And because I know what this L theta is, this is then a half x squared over
on
L.
Okay.
Kinetic energy, potential energy, the m's
big
go,
M's go.
And little h is a half x squared over L. The 2's go, so it's x squared g over L. Now, here's a neat bit. G over L is something to do with the period of a pendulum. So what is the period of a pendulum? The period of a pendulum, T...
Is it 2 pi?
...is 2 pi root L over G. So I've got that V squared is equal to X squared 2 pi over T squared. Wow, everything's squared, so I can say that V is X times 2 pi over T.
Okay, so I got about 3.3 for that. I'm now multiplying it by, in meters, 0.026, which gives me 8.6 centimeters per second.
Well, you did it in centimeters, did you?
No, well, 0.08.
I see. Right, okay, fine.
Meters per second. It's
about 0.1 meters
per second. It's pretty slow.
Right?
Yeah.
And then we weighed the bullet. And the bullet was 2.6. We saw that on the scales.
Grams. Is everything has to be in kilos?
Which is, yeah. Well, if we want the final answer to be...
To be metric, let's do it.
Yeah. So that's 0.0026 kilograms. So you
and
take that speed,
multiply by big M, 9.8 kilos, 1 g of paper, and then divide that by 0.0026. That's kilograms, because that was grams, equals 324.1, not that we need that level of precision, meters per second.
Wow.
That is fast.
That is fast. The speed of sound is about, 340 meters per second.
So that, the bullet was going pretty much the speed of sound. So using all our numbers from the heavy block, we got 324. We are very quickly going to put in the numbers from the lighter block and see if we get a similar result out the other side.
Okay, very quickly.
.2 meters per second.
Well, that's great.
That's not bad. So we're getting pretty consistently around 330 meters per second. Do you have a hunch which you think should be more accurate, the big block or the small block?
So, I mean, I'm pretty happy with this one because we did a few trials on this and we got pretty repeatable results. So I would go for the around 340 meters per second.
Yeah. So just using a pendulum, we got the speed of the bullet. Thanks so much to all of my fantastic Patreon supporters who mean I can come and film someone shooting a real bullet into an actual pendulum, and then we do some legitimate working out. Thank you so much for allowing this to happen. Thank you so much to the Cambridge University Rifle Association who let us come in and use their range, and Katherine for shooting the pendulum very kindly for us. And thanks to everyone from Cambridge University Engineering Department who are frantically packing up and we're getting out because the Rifle Association want their range back. And one final thing to point out is, I guess, the ultimate test. We actually have a packet of the bullets that Katherine was using, and they print the velocity on the packet. And so you can just make out there's a 06 there. That means that they, 061, that means that they do 1,061 feet per second. That's the velocity. And I converted that over, and that's 323.4 meters per second. So we were incredibly close. So what it says on the packet matched our calculations on the pendulum. That is a bullseye. Also, it was quite accurate.